Hello everyone, HBI Guys Model Workshop here with a review of the Polar Lights re-released Back to the Future Time Machine DeLorean. This is a Snap-It kit, which is identical to the Snap-Tight name that Monogram and Revell use, which means that this is a skill level 1 kit made for the small kids that they can snap together. But don't let that fool you. As always, as you see on my channel, just because it is a Snap-Tight kit does not mean that it's only for kids. And that really goes through with these Back to the Future kits from Polar Lights. And they have more than one of these out, and I do own all of them, and we're going to be taking a look at every single kit as we go along here. This video will just be about the Part 1 Back to the Future car, and then we'll go to Part 2 and Part 3 as those cars are reviewed, and you guys get to take a look at all of them and decide which one or all three if you want to buy them. Inside the box, of course, will be your standard set of Polar Lights round 2 models directions. These are all re-releases by them, as far as I know, especially this one. They've come out before, they just might have changed a couple things. It's just a very large page of blown out directions here, because the car is just all snapped together parts. You don't have to use glue. I probably would on some stuff, because I'm an adult and I like building these kits and I want them to stick together, and I don't plan on playing with them, so I would glue them together. It's all going to be in the detail painting for this kit, and there are a lot of parts, surprisingly, for a Snap-Tight kit. And you can see the directions, even though they're all on one page, they are nicely involved. Lots of information for you on there. And then on the back, tells you how to assemble it and paint it, and they do give a paint code for those of us that do want to paint it. And you have the option in this kit, in this particular one, of assembling it with Mr. Fusion when he came back, and to tell the kids that their future selves and their future kids were assholes, if you remember that at the end of the movie. And then, of course, how he gets back from 1955 with the antenna that smacks onto the power line and catches the lightning bolt and produces the 1.21 gigawatts to send him back to the future. Let's take a look at all the cool stuff that is in this re-release. First is a chrome tree. Normally on my reviews, I don't take the chrome trees out because I don't want to scratch the heck out of them. But on this kit, they're not going to need the chrome anyways because these wheels weren't chromed. They do look nice. They do look like the DeLorean wheels. So all you'd have to do is either strip the chrome and paint them, or wash them and dull coat them so that they don't look like they are shiny, shiny chrome wheels, because that's not how they looked on the movie. I don't need to show, you know, link to anything in the description. If you're watching this, I don't know anyone that hasn't seen Back to the Future, so just look at the movie for references on colors if you're ever confused, because the manual's all in black and white. And there's a billion pictures on Google to help you decide what colors to paint everything. Once again, these don't need to be chrome either. Why they wasted time on a chrome tree, I don't know. I suppose it's just for the kids to put it a little something shiny. But this kit does not need it. The DeLorean was stainless steel and brushed aluminum. You know, that you don't need any chrome whatsoever on there. There is a bag of clear parts, and that is a windshield. That one is very, very thin. I love that. Super thin. And very clear through the bag, so there won't be any problems with that windshield. Very well done by them on that. You do get four wheels, or four tires. They're not on a tree. You can see you've got your fatter tires in the rear and your skinnier tires in the front. So there won't be any issues with authenticity on that. Very nicely done. Don't see any seam issues. Let's cover that up. Look at that. Nice tread pattern. Nice looking tires. Thin-walled. Very nice. Little squishy. Doesn't matter. You're not driving it for real. So those are going to look great. And, of course, metal axles. Like a lot, because, you know, kids are supposed to be putting these together, wheeling them around. I'm not doing that. You're probably not doing that. But a lot of people that buy them will. There is a beautiful interior. And like I said, this is really going to impress you for a Snap-Tight kit. All the attention to detail they went into. All this stuff can be detail painted. Get out the craft paints. Start painting all this up. Watch the movie. Pause it. You know, down in my shop, I don't have a DVD player, but I have a VCR and I own all these on tape. So I can just keep pausing it and looking at it for color references. These seats here are very nice. So now, I'm very impressed for a Snap-Tight. There's your fusion reactor. Or the optional Mr. Fusion at the end of the movie. You have the, and then there's your large antenna. Very thin. Very well done. Better than the ones I've seen on the die casts, where they're quite thick. And then just some extra doodads and bits to get things all put together for you. So you can paint a lot of this stuff on the trees, especially very small parts like this. These are more the kind of parts you'd see in a glue kit, but they've got them in here. All this stuff can be painted on the trees very easily because you can see the attachment points are the parts that go inside the holes in the vehicle to snap on. This is the chassis pan. There's no engine, of course, because this is a snap-tight kit, but it does have nice detail in the chassis and the underbody that you can bring out, give it a shot of paint from the airbrush or brush paint it, and then detail all that transmission and engine hardware there. What else do we have? We have a very, very small sticker sheet. I say sticker because these are not decals. These are pressure-sensitive stickers, but they do look nice. There's no dash decals. There's nothing like that whatsoever. So you could go online, see if anybody has Back to the Future decal sets. I don't know. I haven't looked. But the stickers included are very cool. You've either got the California plates or the futuristic barcode license plate on there at the end of the movie when he comes back. We've got some more plastic parts trees. I'll switch sides from the camera. You can see some of the center console here. And then you can see the rear vents. Really nice. Well done. What else do we got? We've got some of the side wiring and cabling on its own little tiny tree. They must have just snapped that off and threw it in the bag. All that you can paint right on the tree because you could see those locator tabs are where it goes into the car. So it'd be very, very easy to do all this on the trees. I certainly wouldn't recommend putting all this little stuff on the car and then trying to paint it. There's its sister cabling. More very fine detail parts. Now you can go and buy Aoshima kits that are considerably more money, and they have probably a little more detail, but for what I'd want to spend on this kit for fun, this is certainly more than enough for me. And this particular kit, this one right here, is currently available at most Hobby Lobbies. So you can get this for 40% off and end up going out the door for about $15. You can see even the interior panels are separate on a snap kit. And they do look pretty nice for the gullwing doors. They've got that cool steering wheel. And then they've got some more wiring and attachment points on that tree. And it looks like we are down to the last gray plastic tree. That's the only color actually of plastic besides chrome. There's the flux capacitor. And I kind of wish that that was smooth and they had a decal for it because you could bring out so much more detail. But, you know, you could always light that too. You know, you could always put and you could also put a clear screen on that if you wanted to. You know, a little piece of acetate across there like they did, and that would look quite nice. So that's very good detailing for behind the seats on the interior. Excellent. Some more electronics. Isn't that very nice? And then we've got the interior dash pod. Look at all that instrumentation. I really wish they had decals for that. And, you know, especially, of course, the dash here, the side instrumentation, and definitely something for the center because there's just no way you're going to be painting all that, you know, November 1955, all that stuff on there. So you just have to do it in little blocks of color. And with, you know, in the black background, same with the gauges. Unless, if you guys can find some Back to the Future decals for the dash, for the DeLorean and stuff like that, link it down in your comments. Let me know. I'll put it in the description so that other people can find them as well. The last part of the kit is the DeLorean body. And on this issue, look at how sweet that looks. They didn't do it in just gray. They did it in a brushed finish. And that, to me, really does look like stainless steel. Just like the real DeLoreans were. I don't think there'd be any reason you'd want to paint that over and mess with it. I don't even think you'd want to gloss coat it or satin it. It just, to me, it has the right texture, the right look. see how close we can get in. It's even a little brushed, as you can see. Look at that. So, you know, it almost looks like it's a die-cast body. But it's not. And even the panel lines are recessed in really nice. You don't even have to wash those out. The only thing that they did that I wish they would have left off was this cabling around the body, which is really, really crisp. But you're going to have to get in there and paint that with a very small detail brush and work on that. But that's the only thing about the body that, you know, that I would have even a mini gripe about. This thing is really friggin' sweet. So there you have it. This is the DeLorean from Back to the Future 1, the first movie. I've got the other ones. We're going to get reviews on all of those, and you can make your purchasing decisions. I had to have all three. There wasn't any way I wasn't going to get them, and I'm so glad that they're pushing them back out. I know this one's a re-release. I'm not sure about Part 2 and Part 3. They're new to me. I've never seen them out before, but they very well could have been re-released, and we'll take a look at those when they come. Thanks for watching. An open box review of the Polar Lights Back to the Future DeLorean Time Machine.